A very good evening to you. Welcome to the FKFPL Review Show. My name is Robinson Okenye. In studio, I am with Cedric Musumba and Rogers Ishtemi. And joining us later will be Steve Ayo via Zoom. We are trying to link up with him so that he can give us his insights on what transpired in round 17 of the Football Kenya Federation Premier League. Now, after 50 days of waiting, the league finally resumed. And in round 17, from the 8 matches that were on the cards, only 9 goals were scored. The gentlemen in studio will be giving us insights on what they thought from the matches that were played over the weekend and probably what to expect going forward now that the league has resumed. Welcome to the show, Cedric and Roger Sishemi. First things first, the excitement is back. We had missed seeing different players take on to the pitch and give us the entertainment that we are normally used to. Cedric.
Indeed, that is an excitement that everyone actually was yearning for. And I think we are now happy to see that the league is back and it started on a very high note, to an essence that there was not too much goals. And it also given us a value of this team that we were coming back at the same level. Seeing FC Leopard picking from where it left, it was actually something that it trickled into my nerves. And it started now actually making me understand that this is a team that is really fighting for the trophy by the essence that it has collected points that each and every person or every fan would have loved to see them actually backing those 3 points. Also, we see the likes of players actually that really maintain their form. We have William Wadri, a midfielder who actually closed at scoring and opened again at scoring. Mm-hmm. Lawrence Juma, who actually came back and still continue from, and as we speak right now, he's actually entered into the top three scorers of the league. And he might be actually yearning to catch up with the top two, who are Elvis Rupia and El Capaito. This is the really flavor that we are just looking for. But and again, there's something that actually wasn't really coming out well, according to me. Mm-hmm. To the essence that everyone will argue out that the league was coming back, it will have started slowly. But there were some silly and stupid mistakes that were being made by the players. We saw some kind of red card actually coming out of these particular matches that were really opening. Mm-hmm. Some were those so stupid enough not to a player to pick such like, for instance, I'm alluding to a red card of Ombija against Gor Mahia.
We'll be getting
at this particular point and juncture. You should not kind into as in invite such kind of red cards into your playing careers.
Mm-hmm. Rogers Ishtemi, welcome to the show. 9 goals from 8 matches. We expected this when we spoke about, you know, the league resuming last weekend. Cedric rightfully said that we may not see more goals being scored on the resumption weekend. And it has happened.
Yeah, of course. Fitness level came to test because after a 7-week break, you don't expect people to come back and bang those goals as they used to do before the league was stopped. But I'm happy to have seen the likes of FC Leopards, Gor Mahia, and Sofapaka getting those crucial wins, as well as Kariobangi Sharks. I think those are the biggest winners because they managed to move them at least on a higher level on the table. But now for Tusker and KCB, I think that was a fair result for both of them because neither of them lost the 3 points. They managed to lose the 3 points, at least they got one. So they are trying to open up the league, and it's going to be as interesting and captivating as expected, because if Tusker will have won, then things will have been totally different. But now, I think this title will go down to the wire. Though already, as we have spoken during the digital show, that by 30th, there will be a team that will represent the country at the Confederation, at the Champions League. But now, after that, then we'll see who is going to win the title come the end of July or early August.
Cedric, let's focus on our first game in tonight's show. That is Gor Mahia getting a 1-0 win against Nairobi City Stars. Karim scoring in that tie. Did you expect it to go that way? Or what were your expectations before this tie actually kicked off?
I did not expect Gor Mahia to come in and win this particular game, given how it was playing previously before actually the lockdown. Mm-hmm. The essence that City Star actually has some kind of good players who could carry the game to the Gor Mahia's door, but that fails actually to come into this particular match. And to any Gor Mahia fan will tell you, it actually ended up winning but it is not a flared Gor Mahia that we are used to. Mm-hmm. They has a lot actually to work around and ensure that Gor Mahia is back to where we used to know it doing. It has those names that any other team will like to covet, but those names are not really gelling up and bringing the value that Gor Mahia should be giving us at this particular time. Seeing them playing, yes, the argument would put them somewhere to the essence that they created some chances, they were bringing in some crosses that actually were not being utilized as supposed to be. Mm-hmm. They were trying to build a game of soccer the same way it has been choreographed and allowed to be played in the pitch. Mm-hmm. But they were not trickling passes as the yesteryear Gor Mahia we are used to. It's not the Gor Mahia that can go ahead and represent the country the same way it has been representing. It will still end up crashing the same way it has crashed during, as in, the current ongoing championship, mm-hmm, and CAF. And that's where Gor Mahia should start picking and recollecting themselves if it wants to go back. No, City Star, it has got some kind of flimsy kind of flairism that I really admired. But the attitude and indiscipline, to an extent, costed them. You cannot go boxing and playing rugby in a game of soccer and expect to win. Mm-hmm. You are really picking players off the ball and you expect to win. You know, players should come to their reasoning now, that they disadvantage.
Now that Cedric, you've mentioned that, I want us to take a look at the red card that was given to Ombija in this tie. What kind of, you know, what was he thinking when this, you know, he decided to elbow his opponent? What was he thinking?
To me, it's a lack of football philosophy. Mm-hmm. Also missing to understand that football has evolved to an extent that it is now on camera. Mm-hmm. To a value that even if an incident happens, referee, yes, has a choice to go and maybe pick a second opinion from their assistants. Mm-hmm. I think he was playing, thinking that he's still playing in the archaic kind of football where cameras were not there, mm-hmm, and he would carry the game given how the fans actually are surrounding, the echoes of the fans surrounding him. Mm-hmm. And whatever he did, you cannot an elbow a player who is not on the ball. Because action, an elbow that comes out of the action can pardon you and maybe, if it's to be punished, maybe earns you a yellow card. Yes. But you, whatever he did, he deserved a red card. And those are the kind of indiscipline that actually Sitsa would not have. What player need to understand that a loss out of 11 player disadvantages a team, no matter how good team it is. Okay, pundits will argue out that a lesser team try to double up the effort, which comes difficult to an opening team actually to penetrate. But this was not the case. Remember, these teams were coming from the COVID break where they were not really managed well in terms of physical fitnesses, and each and even their technical bench will not have actually understood if player kept on going by the instruction they were giving. Mm-hmm. This was a Kenyan kind of a match. It's now you come into a match, yes, that you are required to pick 3 points and you start bringing. If you allow me to be 3 minutes, Six Star carries players that...
Cedric, before we move into that, I want Eshtemi to also give his thought on this red card that was issued to Ombija. I mean, it's not, at this level, it's not something that we should be expecting or be seeing in the game.
That was quite unnecessary, and definitely it cost the team. The team was trying to push Gor Mahia for an equalizer. Unfortunately, Ombija had other thing in his mind. And you know, even as a coach, I'm pretty sure his coach was really disappointed with that action, because he should put himself into that situation. Assume it is Ombija who was the victim. How could he have reacted? Because you know, now everybody is trying to become fit in this resumption level, but now you as an individual, you are coming with boxing tactics, maybe to slow down the opponent. So this was just childish. I think he need to go back and reason, sit back and review himself. What does he really need? Because he's still a young player. He's a player who has been mostly deployed as a winger, but right now he's being used as a striker, because as we have been talking in the previous show, City Stars have been struggling to score goals, and maybe the coach said, hey, let me give a try to this lad so that maybe he can try to show us what he has. Unfortunately, this let him down, and I believe it's going to take a lot of time before the coach maybe try to give him another starting place. Because remember, we have Nicholas Kipkurui, and once Kipkurui gets his fitness level back, I'm pretty sure Ombija will be just watching from the terrace all along.
Mm-hmm. Cedric, I know I interrupted you, but I want us to listen to what Gor Mahia coach, that is Vaz Pinto, had to say after that match, of course, alluding that Gor Mahia should have scored two or more goals in that tie. Let's listen to Vaz Pinto.
I think it was a tough game. The two teams, they play good football, but I think we can score the second goal. We don't score, and of course our game is not was not easy. And I think we control all game. Only one or two balls we concede for City to score. We don't score the second goal. We have many opportunities to score the second goal, and of course, when we don't score, we need to fight until the 90 minutes. But I'm happy because we stop, like I said, before the game, we stop a lot of time, and it's not easy for players come and run like they today work here.
Well, Nairobi City Stars head coach Sanjin, on the other side, was disappointed that they did not manage to pick up a point against Gor Mahia. And he also said that he did not like the behavior of some of his players, of course, such as Ombija, who picked up a red card in that tie.
I can just congratulate my guys because they play outstanding match first half. We were dominant. We have better situation for better chances, better playing style, better ball possession. I was even surprised that we go like that good. Unfortunately, how many times this year happened that we get some stupid goal from I don't know which situation. It was not even the shoot, and little bad reaction are defenders in the second ball. But you can saw today that even with one less player, we try to attack, we try to score the goal. We have some good situation, so I can be sad because we didn't take more points, but I believe we deserve it today.
Yes, that is City Stars coach Sanjin speaking right there. Cedric, let me bring you into this. Sanjin is saying that, you know, he's seen it over this season that they've conceded some goals that, you know, he's not proud of as a coach. You should not concede such goals. There are decisions that his players have made that, you know, have left him disappointed.
That's an attributed to indiscipline that we have just spoken about, Robbie.
Mm-hmm.
Players who are not really picking or playing according to their coach instruction, it means actually they are not as in discipline enough to go by the instruction. And I think as a coach, he need to be telling us which kind of action will he be taking to this player. There are many action that we have seen world-class coaches actually done to even the so-called stars into their team. You can as well as relegate this player to the bench. A team is a composition of either 32 or 27 players. If one player actually starts bringing out some element of not listening to you, what stops you from relegating this player to the bench? And those are the kind of the punishment that all coaches have been actually doing across the world. I will tell you this Gor Mahia City Star match, according to my observation, it was a 50-50 kind of a match that you cannot really come and tell us that my player had position, they played very well, they could score like 5-6 goals. There were no chances to create those 5-6 goals, if you ask me. Neither Gor Mahia or City Star would have bumped into the back of the net even 3 goals. To be given the even, this is a team that were playing as if they were in a friendly match. They were creating, yes, chances, but those chances were so feeble. There were chances that ceremonial to each side of the goalkeeper. And a coach who comes here and tries to tell us is just praying what I normally refer to as psychophilosophy. To an essence that he's trying to tell his player that I am not here to blame, but I'm carrying that blame by myself. And that's what players need to hear. Players need to have a coach who actually carries each and every blame and giving back, going back to the dressing room, trying to correct. And this is what the likes of Aspinto and Sanji trying to tell us. But the truth matter of the issue is that both of the team, they were not at their level best. They were not actually from the level that we left them when we were taking a break.
Mm-hmm.
And they need to go back and reassemble themselves. If they don't actually reassemble themselves very fast, even the 30th June that we are talking about, it will be just for them to watch other teams actually being given that chance to represent Kenya.
Now let's move on from Gor Mahia getting a win against Nairobi City Stars. We move on to the other tie over the weekend, and Caleb Olilo scored the only goal of the match as FC Leopards got a 1-0 win against Nzoia Sugar. I want to bring Roger Sestemi into this. That was one cracker of a goal by Caleb Olilo in that tie. What do you make of the way FC Leopards in general performed in that tie?
Yeah, I'll give a honest opinion on that match. I think it was a 50-50 game, mm-hmm. and FC should consider themselves lucky. Remember, Nzoia really pushed them to the limit, but they were not lucky to find the back of the net. But for FC, it was easy. The boy, Caleb Olilo, took the chance, and there it was. He made the ball look so easy and unleashed a screamer that left the goalkeeper, gave no chance to the goalkeeper. And I'm really proud of how he executed it. The technical aspect, the precision, and the tactic of it, I think it was just top-notch. But also give credit to the assist man. That is, for the first time in the longest time possible, I've seen Rupia giving an assist, and it was through his flicker that the young guy managed to take the ball and shoot it at the back of the net. But Rupia also had a chance. I think he two or three chances that he was also denied by the post. But I believe Nzoia should have at least gotten a point from this game, because FC were not at their best. But now they try to show the character of a champion. You know, character of a champion, by that I mean you need to grind results when things are not even favoring you. And that's exactly what they did against Nzoia Sugar, because breaking a team of Nzoia Sugar caliber is not easy. This is a well-organized team that came to Nairobi with a mission of at least frustrating Leopards and going back with at least a point. But unfortunately, they went back to Bungoma with nothing. So it was a game that any team would have won, but Leopards, with the experience, I think, carried the day. And their coach, I think FC Leopards coach, will be very proud of how his players carried themselves on the pitch. More so, after a few of them had sneaked out of the country, that is in the name of Marvin Abwire and Geoffrey Owiti. But that man on the screen, Austin Odhiambo, mm-hmm. he really proved his worthiness, because you saw the way he dominated the midfield. He made the FC Leopards just follow the shadows, and he was the man who was playing that guitarist as other FC players danced to the song. So I'm really happy with how he played, and he was the man of the match, so he deserved it.
Speaking about FC dancing to the song of the drum, Cedric, when the lineups came out, I know you're among the people that questioned this lineups, asking, you know, where are some of these players? And Estemi has said that, you know, reports suggest that they may have traveled out of the country. But credit where due, FC managed to squeeze out a win in that tie.
It's true. And I agree with Eshitemi that is a win is a win, no matter how it comes, even if it is ugly. Mm-hmm. But and again, you will even agree with me that I have not been a fan of an ugly win. Mm-hmm. I will always like to see a team creating chances out of something that will entice my eye. That's what FC was not really giving. It has just stuck to what it used to give us before even the COVID halted the game. Mm-hmm. FC has been a team of two halves, whereby if you really lock out FC at the first half, the second half they become just frustrated. Mm-hmm. And we have seen this happening over and over and over, whereby FC, when they start of first half, they are pressing, they are trying to trickle passes, they are trying to arrange the game. But after 45 minutes, they become dull. And I think, as also he says, it might have been a character that we don't know. It might also have been a tactic that we don't know. To the essence that once you are ahead, you can as well as manage, provided you come out of that particular win with a head. The only lucky thing that I really liked and adore is that even minus the usual natural starters, mm-hmm. they still try to grind points out of this particular match. And this I'm talking about, they were missing the likes of Clyde Sinanji. Mm-hmm. They were missing the likes of Teddy Sebala, who picked an injury. Mm-hmm. They were missing the likes of Marvin Abwire, as he says, which is actually something that can attract punishment. It's a level of indiscipline I'm talking about, who have flown out of the country. But then again, maybe they might have been flown by the officials. That's a topic for another day. This is a team that has really now known that where the league is taking them, they are only eyeing to the trophy. And that's why you will find them, even where the situation is not really working for them, they will try to manage to come off that particular battle with either a point or collectively 3 points. And now you see where this point has placed this particular team. It has placed them to a very good position to challenge for the trophy. Where Tusker is right now, they are even much more worried to the essence that FC is coming with all hazards actually on them. Mm. And this is what we have been looking for. But now that the coach is back, and the coach, everyone actually thought that he has disappeared, that just like other coach, how they go and they don't come back, he has come back. We are imagining that he has come back to instill the discipline and pick from where he had started from. We want to see FC that trickle passes. We want to see FC that create chances. We want to see FC that hits the target after every now and then, so that they create as many chances. And remember, goals come from those particular chances. If you don't create chances, there's also another element that I learned from this particular team. It's a team that it lacks what we call element of breaking away on a counter-attacking. There's some instance whereby they got a very clear chance that I think it's Sydney. He got a chance actually of breaking away with the ball, but he dilly-dallied, and I think he lacked some kind of creativity to take that ball to the other third of Nzoia, and yes. Then he returned that ball behind. That costed the team. Mm-hmm. Those are the things that they need to start working around and seeing how they will actually take such like chances into goals.
Mm-hmm. Robbie, now, I think I also have to add something on the FC Nzoia game. Mm. I think we also need to give credit to this unsung man called Benjamin Ochan. He was the man against, I think, they reached a time whereby it was Ochan versus Nzoia. Mm-hmm. He literally kept Leopards in the game and won this game for Leopards because he produced some of the very, very impressive saves. And also now for Olilo, I think for him, he just took that chance by his hands. After the departure, the unceremonial departure, or an official departure of those two lads, that is Marvin and Jeffrey, because if they were around, definitely Olilo could not have started. But now he got the chance, and he's the one who won that match for Leopard. So I think it comes a time whereby maybe if you get that chance, if the coach gives you an opportunity, take it by both hands and make good use of it. And that's exactly what Olilo did.
Mm-hmm. But this is a team, Robi.
Yes.
This is a team, and I'm clear, and I think I've been on record on this. This is a team that they need to work very hard on their defensive. Their back four is not really working. Their back four is anchoring on luck. And I think this is what is putting a lot of pressure to Ochan. You see, midfield, they don't have a problem with the midfielder. The likes of Fabrice, they are doing a very good job. The likes of Thiong'o. But you see, the midfield cannot now assume the role of defender. And I think that's why the balls are not going forward. At the moment the defense becomes weak, the second line of defense, which is the midfield, falls back. And that is what is costing this particular
Cedric,
team.
Cedric, it is in such scenarios.
Gentlemen,
just hold on, Robbie. It is in such scenarios.
We are now joined by Steve Ayo via Zoom. And Cedric was talking about, you know, sorting the defense. But I hope, Steve, you've sorted the sound, that we had an issue with that. Welcome to the show, Steve. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine, Robbie. Nice to join the conversation. I was just wondering why you decided to give some two AFC Leopards diehards an opportunity to talk for so long about the club. We are never going to end this. So thank you for bringing that to a stop. But yeah, I think they're just excited. Remember when we last had this discussion, we actually worried what kind of teams you are going to see resume the matches. So, you know, it's been quite a long break, an unfortunate long break. So we really wondered what kind of rustiness we are going to observe from the players and the teams in general. But looks like for AFC Leopard, Gorma here, for Sofapaka, the teams that won this past weekend, it wasn't so bad. I thought the results that they got were quite impressive also against teams that are not traditionally easy for them. So it's good for them. If you are a Tusker, or I think KCB should be really worried. They really performed poorly against Tusker. They only, I think, managed just two shots on target, really, as compared to Tusker, who had, like, I think at least five or seven. So KCB, I should be worried, but kudos to FC Leopards and all the winners this past weekend. It was not going to be easy. They managed to get the 3 points.
Yes. I want us to listen, of course, to Zoia Sugar, coach, that is Ibrahim Shikara. What he had to say after Zoia lost to FC Leopards. Let's listen in.
Lakini nakushukuru Mungu kwa mechi nzuri ambayo tumecheza na FC wamepata nafasi yake na wameza kupata bao. Sisi tumepata nafasi nyingi na tumekosa kufunga bao. So ni kurudi kwa drawing board, then tuanze kuona vile tutaenda kurekebisha makosa yetu. So chances zimetukost. Hiyo mapumziko yao yameleta shida kidogo kwenye timu. Tutakuangalia vile timu tunacheza sio vile tuliachia. So lazima tena tuende tutilie mkazo mahali ambapo tuliachia. Tuendeleze pale pale. Lakini sijafurahishwa sana vile wachezaji wangu pia wanavyo respond kwenye game. Hawajacheza vile kulingana na instructions. But it's okay, we are going back to the drawing board. Mwenyezi Mungu akitujalia, tutaandaa tena turudi mahali penye tulikuwa.
Steve, I want to bring you into this discussion. Of course, that is Shikanda saying that, you know, he wasn't impressed by the way his players reacted in that match. And he expected them to at least, you know, take the chances they had.
Sentiments of a very frustrated coach. You obviously wonder what kind of instructions the players were given that they didn't follow. Sometimes when you're defeated, I think you just have to chin up and just take the loss under your belt really and prepare for the next match. So laying the blame on the players, he had the 90 minutes, he was on the touchline basically just to correct whatever was happening on the pitch. So I normally don't buy that excuse that the players didn't play according to the instructions. If they didn't play the way they were expected to play, that means maybe the instructions are not coming clearly from the touchline. But like I said, I think those are sentiments of a very disappointed coach. But I guess losing against AFC Leopards, given the stature of the club, as much as they've not lived up to it, shouldn't be something really that should make the coach feel like it's a big loss. So let him just prepare his team for the next match. There's still so many games to go.
Mm-hmm. Right now, I want us to listen to what FC Leopards coach, that is Patrick Osims, said after getting a win against Zoia Sugar. Let's listen in before the two gentlemen react to that.
It was not easy because it's like we start a new league, because it's almost 2 months that we didn't play an official game. So the most important was the 3 points, you know. So we knew that we will not be ready, especially physically, and regarding the weeks we had, a little bit special. But we made the job, even if we were a little bit in trouble in second half with all these long balls. But you know, in this kind of game, we had the opportunity. We need to win with a larger score, I will say. So that's a little bit my disappointment today, because in second half we were thinking too much to defend.
FC Leopards head coach Patrick Osims speaking right there after they collected a 1-0 win against Zoia Sugar. Gentlemen, briefly, your sentiments on this. I start with you, Cedric. Patrick Osims is saying that, you know, he expected FC to score more goals and 1-0 was not enough.
We are just on the same page, and somebody will think that we have flown back together with him from Belgium. Because whatever he has just said is what I said earlier.
Yes.
This is not a team actually to sit back against in Zoia. It's a team that would have gone for more goals. And whatever that they did, it's similarly, I'm just disappointed as he is, to the essence that after they have scored one goal, they told that they have won the game, and they started sitting back and inviting pressure. You see, when you sit back and invite such kind of pressure, can actually result into some kind of punishment that you will live to regret. And that's what FC Leopards should not be doing. But I understand where the problem is. It's not that FC sat back to invite pressure. It's only that their back line was not really functioning. It was not collecting the ball the way it's supposed to collect. Give out to the midfield, who would have now distributed the attackers.
So when, why are you not giving credit to Zoia?
No. As Steve has said, in Zoia, losing against FC Leopards is not a big thing, given to the stage of the team.
But we've seen the coach, he was disappointed.
But
that they had chances and they failed to.
Because they decided to sit back as the other, as the counterpart coach.
Just to cut the story short, Cedric is speaking like a fan, I think, from other angle. Just what Steve has said in the previous segment. But I'm warning to Steve, I think we are not here fans. I think we are analysts. So some of the comments we make here are always a honest opinion from an individual. Then, speaking on what Cedric has said, that FC Leopards doesn't need to absorb a lot of pressure from a team like Nzoia Sugar. Mm-hmm. Credit to Nzoia Sugar, they forced FC Leopards to sit back. And I think, to be honest, they really missed the presence of Clyde's synergy in that defense, because once such a composed player misses in the back line, definitely you tend to crumple, and they nearly crumple, but thanks to good game from the goalkeeper Benjamin Ochan, Leopards managed to get at least those maximum points that are really, really crucial in their push for the title.
Mm-hmm. FC Leopards getting the maximum points, which are crucial in their title bid. Now, Steve, the other tie of the weekend that ended in a barren draw, the other week we thought that, you know, this was the game that was going to give us fireworks and expecting lots of goals. But to our shock, it did not come. So what am I talking about? Tusker settling for a barren draw against KCB. What did you make of it?
I wasn't surprised that the two teams shared points. Remember, these are teams that went into the break as the two top teams really in the league. So it was always going to be a very tight encounter, and that's how it proved at the end of 90 minutes. Obviously, like I mentioned before, Tusker created the better chances. They were more threatening in front of goal. KCB were generally poor. I don't feel like they really worked the Tusker defense much. But maybe that's just the tactics that the coach, Zico Otieno, wanted his team to really go through, because remember, Tusker have some very dangerous players who are quite on form before the league was brought to a halt. But yeah, I think a draw was a fair result for both teams. Tusker will be happy, especially with the performance. Mm-hmm.
Cedric, how will KCB take this draw if, you know, things continue going the way they are and probably a different team, you know, wins the league?
It's a fair draw, actually, to pick, because they were playing against the team that was commanding the league. And a draw to them, as my fellow panelists here have said, it's something fair and celebrate. And also, given that they were playing, as in they played the game against 11 players in the pitch, they says that one of their players picked a red card. Mm-hmm. And I think it was a frustrating kind of draw to Tusker. You know, it says that they only managed to come out of this particular battle with 1 point, which they would have collected through the essays that KCB were playing lesser one person. And also, given the pressure that they were giving to the KCB. But the KCB, they were so lucky and they are so happy to have walked out of this battle with 1 point, because they stand a chance of losing the entire three, as in 3 points that come out of this battle with that. But now let's go to how these two teams, the kind of command they were bringing into this particular battle. They were two topmost teams. Their teams, actually, if I go by a player that they have given us, like, for instance, KCB, I expected KCB to bring a lot of pressure to the Tusker's door. Mm-hmm. In the essence, this is a team that has got more player in the national team.
Yes.
It's a team that was carrying, actually, the Kenya national team when we were trading against Togo away. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if players actually went to honeymoon and they forget about doing their work rate. That's why they have come back very low, to an extent that Tusker can put the pressure onto them. But maybe given time, they will recollect themselves and go back to where they was. But it's a good team. It's a good, we cannot judge it based on one game.
Of course, we cannot judge it based on one game. Now, the other tie of the weekend, so Kariobangi Sharks are getting a 1-0 win against Kakamega Homeboys, the solitary goal of the match scored by Patila Omoto. Steve Ayo, Kariobangi Sharks with that win moved to third on the log. Your thoughts?
Very, very, very lofty position to be in right now, especially given the developments in the letter that FKF have actually shared, saying that maybe the teams that finished first and second by June 30th will represent Kenya in the CAF, Confederations CAF, and the Champions League. So that's a lofty position really to be in. And also for Kariobangi Sharks, remember last season they really didn't do so well. I mean, people even wondered if they could face relegation, just like the position that Mathare United are in right now. So having, you know, shaken off all that a loss of form and poor results, you know, towards the tail end of last season or for much part of last season, to third place right now, I think that's a massive improvement, and the coach will be, William Uluya will be very happy.
Roger Sestebi, what do you make of the win for Kariobangi Sharks before we listen to what Muluya had to say and also the reaction from Nicholas Mioti?
I think their captain led from the front. Scoring that important goal means a lot to him. Remember, he has been out for a while with an injury, and on his return here is winning the much important points for the team. Remember, this team is like the dark horses of the league. Nobody's giving them a lot of attention, but they are trying to grind out those results that means to them and when it matters most. And who knows? Maybe they can continue doing like this until the end of the season, and by 30th, they can be the team that can represent the country in the CAF Champions League. Though it is too early to make that call, but I think they have what it takes. They have the quality. They have that energy. They have the character, because them winning this particular game, it gave them a lot of boost. Kakamega is an experienced team with experienced coach who knows exactly how the league is, but coming in with the Muluya is a person also who has been in the league for quite a number of years. He has been a team manager at Mathare. He has been an assistant coach. And here now he's the man calling the shots at Kariobangi Sharks. Remember, he led them to the FKF Betway Cup a few years back. He is the man who managed them as they won that title. So there's no way you can maybe try to rule this team out. And I believe this win is really, really important for the Sharks.
So let's now listen in to what Nicholas Mioti had to say after his side lost to Kariobangi Sharks.
Mi kwanza ndashukuru vijana kwa ile kazi wamefanya. Haijakuwa game rahisi. Sharks wamepoteza pia nafasi zao, tumepoteza zetu, lakini vijana wangu wamejituma mpaka dakika ya mwisho. Nadhani sisi wenyewe tulipopatia bao na hizo chances wamepata, lakini ndio mpira tena kurudi katika drawing board na kufanya tuone kama tarekebisha. Kwanza hatukupata zile clear cut chances. Ukiangalia katika game hiyo second half vizuri, ndio tulikuwa tunafika, lakini hatukupata hizo clear cut chances. Lakini pia tulipata set pieces ambazo pia tungeweza kuzitumia, lakini hatukutumia vile inapaswa. So inamaanisha tu nini, 22 sharpen again. Katika hii game tumepata set pieces nyingi sana, na si kwa kawaida yetu wao wazuri katika kufunga hizo set pieces. So ni kurudi tena katika drawing board na kuwork on them repeatedly, na pia open flow of the game. Saa zile tunapata hizo nafasi tuweze kucreate more chances so that we can at least score a goal.
Kakamega Homeboys coach Nicholas Mioti speaking right there. Cedric, from what we've heard Mioti say, it's that he's optimistic that, you know, he's going to clear out some of the few challenges that he had, and then the next game probably he might be picking up 3 points.
Indeed, he's optimistic, but whatever he's saying, it's so hard to come by one day. Remember, he has talked about no chances, a team not creating many chances. Mm-hmm. He has talked about a team not actually bringing into the value of clear-cut chances. Mm-hmm. That reminds me of lack of creativity that can create those chances for the team.
Yes.
And if you lack players that can bring the element of creativity in the team, Forget about chances. Mm-hmm. We have seen all creative players supplying balls to strikers, or sometimes going by themselves, taking those chances, what we normally refer to brilliancy, Individual brilliancy, and score. If that lacks into your team and you come here telling us that you will go back and correct, forget about that particular team.
Eshtemi, you are laughing from Cedric's sentiments.
I always like the way Cedric forces his statement, or rather try to put it across. Yeah, that is absolutely true. It can't work in a day. Of course, each and every team is coming from that lull after the break. But now it's all upon how you respond on the first match. And this has already been shown how those teams that managed to win and those that lost, they have actually to rethink and re-strategize, just like Homeboy's coach is trying to say. But it's not going to be an easy thing for him, because there's a lot of congested fixtures. There will be no room for him to maybe try to implement the new things that they didn't do. For those few teams, maybe they use that break to maybe try to tell their players, or rather train their players, on how to apply new stuff once the league resumes. That they did it maybe virtually. But now, once you lose that a game that you start with after maybe such a break, it is really, really, really demoralizing. And that tells you how Mioti is frustrated. But on the other side, I'm pretty sure Muluya is a happy man, because that win is really, really important for the Sharks, like I've said in the earlier minutes.
Now that you've spoken about Luya, let's listen to William Luya, what he had to say about his team getting maximum points.
Tunashukuru ni nafikiri mmeona ni bidii ambayo imewekwa na vijana haswa kwa maana kushinda mechi bao moja kwa nunge ni bidii kwa maana tulifunga mapema na pia labda tukazuia vyema hadi kaisha. Kuna nafasi nyingi na vile umemsema labda James Mazembe amekuwa mmoja wao. Kumekuwa pia na Luasa ambaye amekuwa mmoja wao. So tuna striker wangu ambaye ni Kapaito. Ni mechi ambayo ilikuwa vyema kwa maana tumekaa sana bila kucheza. So ni mechi ambayo at least tumeona yale ya kurekebisha. So labda kwa mechi ambayo inakuja ya ulinzi tutanoa zaidi pale mbele tupate mabao mengi.
Ndio.
Haswa Kuol Chol, kuna Geoffrey Shiveka, kuna goalkeeper ambaye ni Brandon Brian Bwire amekaa sana bila kushika na kumekuwa pia na Boniface Onyango. Lakini pia inaweza kuwa ni itihada ya watu watatu lakini kwa wote ambao kwa ujumla wachezaji 11 haswa wale wameingia na wale wamecheza wote wamepeana fursa nzuri.
William Luya speaking right there after they got a 1-0 win against Kakamega Homeboys on Friday. Remember, their game was the first on resumption of football activities in the country. Steve Ayo, Luya is saying that, yes, we have picked this win, but remember, teams are still trying to come to terms about, you know, the fitness level of the players they have at the moment.
Yeah, and I think it will take maybe 2 to 3 games for us really to know the fitness level of most of these players. Their next kick about against Ulinzi, as Mule has said, in Narok, I think will be a good measure for him to see whether, you know, that win that they got this past weekend was a fluke or not. Remember, Ulinzi is never really an easy team, especially defensively. So obviously, James Mazembe, who is almost hitting double figures as far as assists are concerned, I think he'll have a game really on his shoulders to just show, you know, what kind of a player he is. I mean, he's already proving what value is adding to that Sharks team, obviously making the absence of Harrison Mwenda, who left for AFC Leopards and was quite an influential player, seem like, you know, it's really nothing. So I think with Sharks, you always know what they are going to give you. Normally, very technical. You know, they are very technically astute. They are very fit as well. You know, they are always running around the pitch, covering every blade of grass. You know, from the first to the very last minute. So you know, they are very honest players who will always give you 100% effort. But so is the soldiers, Ulinzi Stars. So I think it's going to be a very good match. Which also Coach Muluya will just get to gauge and see whether, you know, third place right now is a good position for them that they can build into, or maybe they'll start faltering along the way. But yeah, let's see what kind of game that Sharks will have against Ulinzi.
Yes. I think Sharks also have their own tactical weaknesses. And for those team or other coaches who have not watched this team, maybe this is a secret I'm trying to give it to you. Once you lock out maybe 2 or 3 players in that Sharks team, that team is completely dead. And that is maybe from Mazembe and then maybe Sakari. Those two players, once you lock them out, then it will be so difficult for Sharks maybe to express or rather to show off that quality game they have been showing. Because I saw them, it was against Leopards and also against, I think, 3 games or so. Once those two players, yeah, they were kept off, Sharks literally struggled in that game and they ended up, I think, losing or rather getting a point. So those two players, Sakari and then Mazembe, as my friend Cedric always call him, they are very, very important players for Sharks.
Yes, Binko traveled to Mombasa and they managed to come back to Thika with a point. Cedric.
You know, you stopped me when I wanted just to jump into Sharks.
We are running out of time.
I know, but I needed just to remind Rogers that Sharks plays without Danny Sakari, mm-hmm. and they truly neutralized Kakamega Homeboys. Mm-hmm. That's actually what resulted to Muyoti saying that they did not create chances. Mm-hmm. It tells you, even without Danny Sakari, he still has some strength in the bench that can come in and fill the gap of Danny Sakari. Mm-hmm. And that's a development to Muluya's team, because I agree with what he has said. But if he can manage to bring in absence of the player that we know, mm-hmm. and they still live to the mark, then it means he's working on something.
Mm-hmm. To Mombasa.
Bidco and Bandari, it's a so disappointing results to Bandari. Because mm-hmm. remember, Bandari, just like Sharks, they were trying to recreate themselves and try to catch up with the leading pack. But and again, Bidco all the way from Thika to Mombasa, they used all their arsenals to whatever they think to fry them at the coast. And that actually what is really not working to this coast area, as in the DOCA team, to the SS, that I think their ambition to maybe go ahead and try to challenge for the trophy is as well as fading away from them. Though they have some brilliant players. We have been here talking about the likes of William Wadri. But the problem with players and coaches, and I don't know why, and at the moment they convert their midfielders into a striker, and they start getting goals, they tend to forget to go ahead and try to look for other supportive players who will really go ahead and support these players to get more goals. This is a team that actually, if Wadri is not scoring, it's struggling. And you see, in each and every match, he goes on giving them goals. At the moment he stops scoring, if he scores one goal and the opponent equalize, they end up picking a draw. That's a very dangerous way of trading with a player in the teams of Bandari Stecha. And I think this is what Kasambungo, who doesn't actually want to come out and speak each and every time we invite them to the lad, to start assuming and bring those values that he was hired for to come and do into this particular team. Or else,
yes,
this is a team that will not challenge whatever they think they can challenge at the top there.
Mm-hmm. 30 seconds, Ishtemi, Western Steamer held a poster Rangers to a 1-1 draw. 30 seconds.
Yeah, of course, team have been struggling. I think a point against Rangers, Zuhed, but just had another impressive form before the league was halted. I think for the coach, that is the veteran Abdallah Juma, that is a good result for him. Remember, Rangers had really done well before this league was halted, and them being at least, I think they're close to each other in that relegation zone, and for them to share those 3 points, those 1 point, I think it is motivating and encouraging for Steamer compared to Rangers. So I think they're very disappointed. They expected to win, but that's the nature of football.
Steamer, you, Mathare, were held by Viga. 30 seconds as we wind up.
Two teams also who are not in the best of forms, obviously struggling on the wrong end of the table. Fair result for both teams. Obviously, none will be happy with that. They felt like they were in the same level, so the points were really up for grabs for everyone. Fortunately or unfortunately for both of them, they had to share the 1 point. So good result, really, at the end. None of the teams should feel like they didn't get what they deserved. Yeah, and looking forward now to the next match for both.
Looking forward to the next match for both. Thanks a lot, gentlemen. Steve Ayo, Rogers Ishtemi, and Cedric Musumba for giving us your insights on what you thought about the resumption weekend of the Football Kenya Federation Premier League. We had 8 matches, 9 goals scored, and hopefully we'll be seeing more goals scored as we head into match day 18. My name is Robinson Okenye, and that is how we wrap it tonight. Have a good night. We'll be seeing you again next week on Monday from 10:30 p.m. to 11:30.